Welcome to this class. It's a general education course for CISG 113, and it is section 1. The title of this course is Information Security and Privacy. It's a course offered by the Faculty of Science and Technology in coordination with the Faculty of Business Administration. It's a general education course for year 1 or year 2 students. It does not require any prerequisites. I do not assume you know anything technical. I just assume that you got through secondary school. You have the basic literacy ability to read, to write, and to think. Okay? So it's a very interesting course, and it's not a difficult course. Over the past 4 years, and this is the fifth year, this course has served a total number of 350 students. Okay? And over 95% of this student, actually 98% of the student passed the course with flying colors. Only those small number of students who failed because they did not do anything and didn't come to class, so it cannot be done anything, all right? So I hope you enjoy this course. It's not going to be a difficult course, as I said, but it's a course where I'm going to produce some learning from each one of you. Produce learning. What do you mean by produce learning? So in any course of your study at the university, you could expect to do something, all right? And if you do that something which is productive enough to produce learning, that's the purpose of this course. And what are some of the differences between a general education course and a major disciplinary course? Well, to me, it is this. A disciplinary course put a lot of emphasis on the content knowledge, where we instructor have to make sure that we give it to you class after class, time after time, and we often have a test on you to see how better or how best you can reproduce the knowledge, because these are very important for your chosen major. But in a general education course, content is important, but not as important as what we believe is the key. And instead, the general education course carries with it a very important mission, that is to produce learning in you. And what does it mean? Well, to paraphrase a little bit, it's to help you to transition from being a taught to learn student to a learn to learn student. What do you mean by a taught to learn student? And what do you mean by a learn to learn student? Well, a taught to learn student means you consider yourself as a person who has this much ability to learn something. So you need a teacher to guide you through. Well, it's reasonable. Everyone learns something like this. But in the context of the college years, you have to learn how to be your own teacher, okay? To make sure that you can teach yourself to learn something. Well, the difference between this is when you have the ability to become your own teacher, you can do anything you like. And that is exactly what is meant by a lifelong learning skill. Grab your seat, you're welcome, okay? So my interpretations for a general education course is to enable each one of you to transition from a taught-to-learn student to a learn-to-learn student. And these will be very important for your college year. So remember that. Keep this in mind. All right? Then the second thing I would like to introduce to you is in any course of study, when you walk into the classroom the first time, you need to look for one important information, and that is the syllabus of the course. So when you look at the Moodle environment, the syllabus of the course is put immediately under my banner. So you can always find Learning Center syllabus in this course. So now let me click into the Learning Center syllabus. And so you can see the syllabus appears right in front of your eyes. Allow me to say that I did not print the syllabus for each one of you because I love the trees. I didn't want to waste the paper. So please come to the Moodle environment and read it here. And if you really want to read the paper versions, print it out on your own expenses at your own home, all right? So for me, forgive me, I do not want to produce more than 50 sets of these pages. Okay, the The syllabus contained five individual parts. Part A, which is the most important information you need to get yourself aware of. Part B, also important. C, D, and E, well, I would say these are supplementary information for you to understand what type of teacher I am and what I expect you to do and why. Okay, you need to ask the question, what are we supposed to do in this course and why are we doing that, for what purpose? And if you read syllabus C, D, E, okay, you can find interesting answers. All right, so let's go through this. Now, this is a general education course categorized under IT and Knowledge Society. It's a group of general education course which will help you to understand something about IT and Knowledge Society. And this group of GE course is under one big category called Science and Information Technology. Okay? Now, we're going through some changes in our GE program, but until the real new GE program comes up, this is still very much valid. And this GE course will give you 3 credits. Okay, 3 credit means each week we're going to have 3 hours of contact between you and me, face to face in a classroom environment. And we do it this way, we're going to meet 2 times each week, and so each time we're going to spend 1.5 hours. But in the contact of the school's administrations, you really cannot use up 1.5 hours, so we just have 75 minutes to make sure 15 minutes will be reserved, we didn't move around. All right, so I need to run at the end of the 75 minutes to another class. Fortunately, it's in the office in the next building. Yesterday, I didn't want to course on the campus. That's a challenge, not just for you, me too. All right, so it's a course about information security and privacy. That's a very interesting term. It's a very interesting phenomenon. So if you go through the syllabus, I give you a bunch of things which I'm not going to walk through with you, but I admit it, I'm going to help you understand it from a different angle. So, okay, you can read it. Okay, you can read them. All right. So the second thing I would like to introduce to you is, oh, there is indeed a textbook for this course, but I will not force you to buy it because it's going to be expensive. The textbook is available in the library, textbook sections, where you can actually go and look up individual chapter and Xerox them on your own. Xerox means fully copied. Now, most of the contents of the chapters have already been extracted and put it in the Moodle environment. That's why when you visit the Moodle environment, many of you did, and check it. You can see the 15 widths, actually 14 widths of the materials there, including the submissions link, assessment report, midterms, and whatever it is. It's already there, so make sure you visit it. And actually, it's very important that I expect each one of you to visit the environment at least 3 times a day, morning, afternoon, and evening, all right? Because you will see different things updated there, all right? But mostly, you can see that what are the contacts and what are the contents you will be introduced and what you're supposed to do there. All right, so in a minute, we'll get back to the Moodle environment. The textbooks, the references are available from the library. Now, let me tell you a little bit of my expectations as a teacher. Well, I would say that learning is basically more than an individual process. It's actually the process which involve at least one more person, and that's why in this particular class you are supposed to do a lot of the group-based project work. You will first of all need to find a learning partner in the first week or first 2 weeks of the class. Okay, you need to find one learning partner. That's why I will give you time to introduce yourself to the whole class, and I also expect you to at least make 3 friends in this class to level down who's going to be your learning partner in the first 2 weeks, okay? And as you get to know one another better, you need to identify your team members. So first of all, you need to work in pair, which involve 2 persons, you and your learning partner, and you need to identify who is going to be your learning partner at the end of the 2nd week, all right? Second thing is, you're going to work in group, that means more than 2 persons. That's why when you got your pair ready, and you're going to find another pair, and the 2 pairs will be formed into 1 group. Okay, we have 50 students in this class, or I expect 25 pairs, and about 13 teams, all right? The second thing, is we have to use a lot of the e-learning platform called the Moodle environment, and at the University of Macau, it is called the UM Moodle. All right, and that is a very important thing. It's just like your textbook, but it's more than a textbook because you have to do a lot of things in the Moodle environment, submitting your homework, downloading the notes, watching the videos, and working with your partners. All right, discussions through the forums, writing report together through the wikis, and then you need to maybe chat together. All right, and my office hours will be physically in my office and virtually through the Moodle environment, which is 24/7. And the third important thing which I expect you as a student of this class to be aware of is that learning is never a spectator sport. It's never a spectator sport. That means you're not here to watch the show, and I'm not the performer of this show. Okay? So you're here to learn something, and to learn that something, I expected that it's going to be a down-to-earth process, a pragmatic process. And these processes of learning involve doing something, all right? So in the class that we meet, we're going to expect you to do something at least a little bit together, all right? So that is a very important process. So do not consider, oh, this teacher is a poor performer. I'm not going to pay the ticket anymore, all right? So expect me to tell you frankly on day one of this class, okay? Learning is never a spectator sport, and you're here to learn through a pragmatic process of doing something, all right? So in this course, I have given you three very simple objectives, okay? First of all, as your teacher, I have the responsibility to give you what you need to become literate about the subject, information security and privacy. So I need to conduct some lecture, but the lecture will not be long. Psychologist tells us our attention span cannot be more than 10 minutes. So my lecture will be very short, except for today. I need to give you a little bit more, so I'm actually using 15 minutes today. I'm stepping into the danger zone. The second thing is, after I've given you something, that means you did the internalizations of the knowledge which I provide you. Somewhere within you, you need to do some processing. And after you've done the processing, I expect you to externalize the knowledge. The way to externalize the knowledge is to enable you or to encourage you to formulate your personal perceptions or perspective. What's going on there? What do you think? What's your positions there? And how are you going to deal with the situation when you were that particular person, the victim, all right, of information insecurity, or the victims of being having your privacy violated, okay? So what are you going to do? You express your views. How are you going to do that? Well, you can do it through the conversations in class. You can do it through a formal discussion forum, where you need some records of your written comments. You can do it as a presentations, or you can do it as a case study, storytelling, all right? Or you can do it in the report, or your personal digital story, which you might have to submit it if you choose to. And so, internalize the knowledge, externalize the knowledge. What's the purpose of doing that all the time? As human beings, we learn through a process of integrating new things into the existing framework of knowledge that we have. And if we become interested in doing it because of the subject engages us, then we will have a certain degree of awareness heightened in each one of us. So we become sensitive to understand something in that particular area. And that's the purpose of point number three. I would like to see if I could, through the discussions in this course, in the context of information security and privacy, increase the awareness of each one of you concerning the impact of information security and privacy in the computer industry. That means where we live today, because we impact by a lot of technology. I bet more than 95% of all of you sitting here will have your mobile phone in a minute. We are going to check it. All right? Okay, so that will be very interesting. Now, why do we have so much facility today to help us to communicate with others? Because we are alone together. We are alone together. Okay. Do you understand what I mean? We are alone together. topics cover. Okay, in this context, we would like to give you some topics because in each course, you're going to learn something. So under the IT and Knowledge Society category and GE Education, we have some common modules. As you can see, common module 1, 2, 3, and 4. We're going to give you some previews on what is meant by information technologies and knowledge society. What do they mean? The second thing is, what is meant by ethics and social responsibility in the information age? Ethics, it's a very abstract term. Social responsibility, do I need to clean the rubbish in front of my house? Okay, and common module number 3 is digital divide in the 21st century, those who have something and those who do not have anything. We are fortunate enough to live in Macau where we do seem to have a good living environment where digital resources are okay, but there are many people in the world, including those in Macau, they do not have anything, they do not have access to those things. And how are we going to bridge the gap? Okay? And then module number 4 is literacy. Information literacy and competency. Literacy is the state of being something. Information literacy is the state of being literate in the use of information, in the use of researching certain information. And competency means the skills acquired to do that. All right. So we will explore those things further. And then we come to 7 important topics in the context of information security and privacy. Number 1, privacy and encryption. Privacy is something that belongs to me, not you, so you're not supposed to look at it. But if you happen to look at it without my permission, you are intruding my privacy. Also, to help myself not being dipped in porn by other people without my permissions, let's try to encrypt something. When we do anything in transmission, encryption means to convert something from an explicit form into an implicit form. And how can you decode an implicit form? Only with a certain key. Alright? And then web attacks and internet vulnerability, second topic. Well, I just got a message when I used my computer this morning. They say, hey, your password has already been compromised by hackers. Please change your password as soon as possible, or anything bad is going to happen that would not be desirable. Have you received a message like this? When you install your antivirus software in your PC, or once you install it, and when you try to log onto some kind of system, when you type in a password which happened to be compromised by hacker, your system is going to send you this message. It's a kind of web attack. Behind the scenes, a lot of hackers do 24/7, intruding our computer without understanding. And when we install antivirus software in our PC or notebook, they will remind us something like this, okay? Because of what? Vulnerability. Vulnerability means there is a porn or service in a particular system where people can easily punch into it and without hurt. The system has holes, okay? Every day, our ICTO colleagues are doing the best to protect it. Our information at the university from being hacked. And every day they're phishing emails to ask us to provide information. You read that email from ICTO yesterday, right? And then, ethical issues of hacking and cracking. Is there anything good by doing something bad? When you hack into something, it's an act of intrusion. It's supposed to be something bad. But is there anything good coming from people who are doing hacking? Yes. In the real world, that's called ethical hacking. They do it for good, okay? They do it for good. And most of the time, they're done by former hackers. They're on the bad side of the story. And they are called the white hats now. In the past, they called it black hat. Okay? So it's very interesting, white and black. And anything in between gray, sometimes they do something good, sometimes they do something bad, and they never tell you. Okay, information fraud, something that it's easy for us to get trapped into, but not camera. In a minute, today it's very rush, in particular for those who cannot speak in Cantonese, you may not understand or appreciate that. But anyway, we're trying to say something about the information you provide, or about the information you receive, that is going to hook you into a story, a situation in which you never discovered you are in danger until you're already in danger. Okay, wireless network security. My notebook now is using wireless connections, and at home, I get 95% of you got CDM, fiber optics connections, and you have a virus router there, and you, if I won't drive my notebook in front of your house and test, oh, you're using this wireless network, and I intrude into that, okay? Oh, and many of us are very naive, we never said password. Many people can come and use it and steal information. Computer crimes is a very, very serious thing. It's more than fraud. Fraud is a trap. Crime, it's an act, okay? So, and then countermeasures, can we do something to stop them? And what are the techniques? And is there anything the government can do for us in terms of door making? So all of these will be contexts of our study. Is it interesting? Maybe. If you're interested, okay? And then this is not a technical class because we do not have a lab, but it's a class to help you think about situations of concerns and help you educate yourself. And so we're just a 3 hours content each week. And altogether we have 42 hours of lectures, and I expect that when you do your studies, you have to add another 40 something, and 90 hours altogether in this course, including the class hour learning efforts, okay? And then in this course, we have some assignment, actually three assignment, and each assignment is called a learning contract, and I call it learning contract 1, 2, and 3. And each of these assignments are meant to help you to learn, pick up the learn to learn skills, and they are not very highly graded, so only 30%. But there is a project after the free learning contract that's called a learning portfolio, where you put things together and put it in your personal profile. And that will give you 20% and altogether 50% already. But for the other 50%, 15% will come from the midterm, and 35% will come from your formative efforts. So if you spend 20 hours doing your learning contract number one and you discover you just got 10%, even though you got through 10%, it does not seem to do well. What? I tell you what, if you spend 20 hours doing your learning contract one, and if you keep track of what you do in the 20 hours of the semester, you can use that record with the evidence of your doing and you can claim 15% of your learn-to-learn score. That means you can use the same set of effort to get score from this, to get score from that, all right? So this learn-to-learn activity, normally my student will do a lot of the journals and discussions details and also write the blogs, okay? And so towards the end of the semester, you can tell me that, well, even though I got 5 points out of 10 points in learning contract number one, but actually I wrote 3 learning journals, did 2 discussions forum, and actually 3 blogs. So you can use this evidence of your work and claim some score out of your 15%, all right? So there's certain criteria, you can read it. And then in-class participations. We have 75 minutes each class, and normally I will speak in the first 30 minutes, and I will reserve the second 30 minutes to be the floor open to all the students who would like to share something in class, and I will send out call for participations 1 week before, and every week I will do the same, and you sign up for your own slot. When you sign up for your own slot, I'll give you 5 minutes time, and you will come here, pick up the microphone and tell the whole class what you want to tell, maybe the, based on your learning, based on the story you discover, but you have only 5 minutes, and then you keep track of those in class sharing, presentation, discussions in your personal records book in the Moodle environment, and towards the end of the semester, you can use this record to earn or to claim a 20% score. Then it's a formative assessment. It's one way to encourage you. You are the owner of the classroom, and I will be listening to you. Thank you, teachers, all of your teachers. Okay? All right? So you want a little bit about the assessment. So after that, it will be a very simple schedule of work. These are the suggested coursework items you need to do in order to keep the evidence of your work. You can study them. It's a very simple picture. But compared to this, definitely you need to go to the Moodle environment to see the resources. Okay? And let's see. Yes, Ray, I still use this table to give you a grade. So you can earn your points in such a way that you want to have an A. That means you must reach a very high level. 100 points is the total. Is at least 93 points to get an A. 88 points to get an A minus. There is a system to convert your points there if you look at the Moodle environment. Okay? So here we go. Let's go back to the Moodle environment. At this point, this is day number one, okay? You can see day now, each week you have a block in the Moodle environment. This is week number one, from 2015 August the 24th to 2015 August 29th. You have day number one is today. And day number two is this Friday, okay? Same group. And then we're in learning contract number one already, and the theme behind the learning mode is inquiry-based learning, okay? IBL, meaning questioning. Okay, and the topic for this week is what is information security and what is information privacy. And so day number one, I have already walked you through some of this, but you're responsible to go for each one of this link, which is from a support website. For example, go to a calendar. You can see the calendar for this particular course. It's, we have 14 weeks and you need to submit something for the first learning contract, the first assignment in the week number four, okay? And then for the second learning contract, you have to submit something in week number seven. And finally, for learning contract number three, the week number 10. Now, I do not need to remind you, you need to read them, okay? Everything is already set there. Calendar, submissions, what are you going to submit, all right? And you are in charge, okay? Everybody is going to submit the same set of items, but the topic will definitely be different because you're going to choose a topic. Okay, you're going to choose the topic based on the learning contracts area. That means you have a lot of freedom to tell us what you learn. Okay, and as a teacher, my job is to accommodate as much as possible. And then there is a midterm exam in week number 11. After that, you will be doing a project, and the project will be submitted week number 13, and the project is actually a learning portfolio. Okay. And then we have a semester review. Since we do not have first day classes, we do not need to come back on week number 15, which is for only first day classes. So that is the calendar. Well, after that, you have done the calendar. Okay, let's go back here. So you can see that you can also see the reading per week. I have suggested a reading list for each week. So you can study the reading list here, which is connected with the topics of interest that I mentioned to you. And your job here is to make sure to get yourself acquired enough knowledge on a specific topic so that you understand how to share, all right? So it's a system of learning, so based on this topic. And then the submissions, definitely, I told you already three times, okay? And then next week, you need to submit your learning partners' information through your personal forum in the Moodle environment. What is the personal forum? Well, the personal forum in the Moodle environment is this. Each week, I give you some tools to keep track of the learning. So week number one, two to track the learning. You have a learning online learning journal. You can take notes, okay? You have an online public discussion forum where you can actually leave the message to the whole class. And then you have a Dr. Vett's Q&A hotline. That is your personal forum because that is for each one of you. Now, in a public discussion forum, when you share something, the whole class can watch it, read it. But in the Dr. Vett's hotline, each one of you will dedicate a chamber to talk with me. What you share there will not be revealed to the whole class except you and me. Okay? Because that is your personal forum. And then at the end of the first week, you need to write something as the feedback of this class. Okay? So that is your job, homework. Okay? Before this Friday is to walk through each one of those things, learn them, okay? See what you can get out of it, all right? Okay, that's your job, all right. So what are you going to learn today? Let's walk into day number two, okay? Oh, before that, let me just go through this. You know what you need to do. But how much time do you need to spend in this class per week? 6 hours. Very simple, 6 hours. 6 hours per week. And that is a very frank disclosure for a teacher. If you don't spend 6 hours per week, it will be very hard for me to imagine the problems of the work. And normally, 6 hours and 1 hour reading, 1 hour writing a journal, 1 hour doing discussions online, 1 hour doing collaborations with your friends, be it online or physical, and 1 hour writing reports. Report cannot be done in 1 day. Okay. And then you have face-to-face meeting with your friends 1 hour. That is outside the classroom. Okay. Together with the 3 hours inside the classroom, it's 9 hours. Is it difficult? Well, I don't think it's too difficult, but it's a challenge. Okay? It's a challenge to lead you into the second learning contract. The second learning contract is based on the idea of SRL. Remember, the purpose of this course to help you to transition from being taught to learn student to a learn to learn student. And being a learn to learn student, you must learn to be in charge. And one thing that you must be in charge is how best to make use of your time. It's very important resources. So how are you going to spend 6 hours? Well, my suggestion to many students is divide 1 hour into 10 6 minutes slot and ask yourself how you're going to distribute the 10 6 minutes slot through 1 week for reading. And if you have 1 hour to do writing, say I spend 15 minutes each time to write. So 1 hour means 4 15-minute, so I'm going to spend 4 times writing this week, where I'm going to distribute a 15-minute slot for the week. Okay? And if I'm going to have 1 hour talking with my friend, so let's do it 5 minutes each. So 12 5-minute slot talking with my friend throughout 1 week. Which slot I'm going to do that? Okay? So you need to be in charge to think a little bit about things like that. Resource management is very important. Okay? So let's go back here. Oh, there's something very, very important that I cannot escape without doing that. Remember at the heading of each block, okay? You can see that I often give you a piece of music to see you up. And then at the end of that you have week one. Read something like it before class, during class, after class, and end of week activity. Now these are what we call teacher's tips. I expect that before you come to class, this is something you need to get ready. That's read the before class activity. And during class, I tell you that what we're going to do during class. After class, now you have already done something before that and you experienced the class. Then what are you supposed to do after class? That is within 1 week. And at the end of the week, what you should have obtained. Okay? So each week I'm going to give you some reminder items. With that setup, which is called a branded learning approach, you don't just come to class and do learning, but you are actually managing your learning throughout the week, be it inside the classroom or outside the classroom. So it's a very important training to become college student. Okay, I hope you understand what I mean. Okay, I'm going to stop at 2:15, right? Okay? So I think I've already spoken enough, more than 30 minutes. So I have to stop at this point. And I have to let you know what is meant by information security and privacy. And I have to say to those who cannot understand Catholics today, my apologies, because that is one of the story that I discovered recently, and which is very important. But for those who can understand Mandarin, it's still okay. But for those who cannot understand both Catholics and Mandarin, wait. I have enough for you, okay? So let's go for it. It's not strong. Let's do it from the very beginning, okay? Because I do not mean to cut the time. I fixed the sound next time. I cannot change this.珠海、香洲分局，咁電話。
力嘅牛正方比例，偵查大隊係真嘅，不過就冇牛正方。朝早，我哋將手機接駁到海林電話，佢講準時打嚟，要我哋將電腦防盜軟件解除，之後再登入一個網站。我哋按指示輸入編號同密碼，隨即就出現黃利嘅資料同案情。涉案嘅不法金額達到284萬，我哋話要親自去摧毀。佢要我哋當日將20000現金存到工商銀行北京一間分行國家金融局霍建達入户口，仲指定喺酒店點度匯錢，唔可以去銀行。究竟有冇國家金融局嘅咧？有北京市金融工商局、國家財政局，但係就冇國家金融局，亦都揾唔到一個叫做霍建達嘅官員。匯款嘅期限到啦，對方再打俾我哋。上海的餐廳是由香港人聽嚟管理，佢亦都係藝人李潤嘅經理人。自問對錢銀都算精明，不過一年前呢部電話聽嚟就令李潤達欠咗100萬。當時係朝早嘅8點幾，有人打冒北京朝陽區公安部嘅電話號碼打俾佢，話佢涉嫌洗黑錢、開賭博、殺人等，仲要佢登入一個公安網站，上面除咗資料，仲有佢回鄉證相。艾莉更加感覺到俾對方一直監視緊。
我係一路著住個死衣嘅，好坦白講，佢突然間同我講話，佢將翻件衫裝到啲同我講嘢，我好驚。咦？而家冇佢嘅攝相，即係佢入侵咗我，同埋開到個電腦有攝相啊嘛。即係我佢入咗我電腦睇到我咧，跟住我嚇到咧，我即刻著衫，佢仲講得出。我每一日去
哪
間銀行出入？
編導仲知道佢第二日會去北京，聲稱佢報案嘅時候就會被捕。Ellie 好驚，於是用按片圖嚟展示，用公司嘅電腦做咗一啲步驟，再將用嚟確認交易嘅 USB 手指插入電腦，打咗個 OK 掣。
佢話：你撳一撳
個
OK 掣得㗎啦，咁樣我係撳過嘅，但我真係冇。
錢係屬於黎明利若行的，戴莉即刻報案，對方懷疑佢嘅電腦同手提電話被入侵，對方控制咗佢嘅電腦做網上轉帳，亦 唔少食少量，呢間餐廳提供免費 WiFi 俾顧客上網。網絡保安專家楊和先生喺二樓做緊啲咩咧？
好多時間咧，我都諗唔到啦。咁咧，我做法咧就係咧，取曬所有佢嘅通訊咧，就係逼佢哋嘅通訊咧嚟攞你部機先。咁啊，咁我部機咧拆曬佢之後咧，就我自己咧放翻出去，打出個世界上。
世界儲存咗好多機密資料，包括無處不在、手提1200萬。最近有黑客公布一項新嘅技術，透過多媒體信息 MMS 入侵，讓小手提電話預設咗自動接收。黑客只要發放植入咗無碼程式嘅 MMS， 就可以完成入侵大量電話。電話中咗又會點嘅咧？由我身份呢部手提電話裝咗一個黑客程式，
咁我 Apps 喺部手機裏面咧，呢部手機就會主動咧係黑客嘅機器。咁黑客咧見到呢部機走嚟咁大嘅時候咧，咁我知道就話呢個人轉咗計劃。咁咧我就可以移動翻嚟。睇下咧，睇下呢個 contact list 咧係喺度咧。
電話本身儲存咗3個電腦人，任何身份全部都會有。呢一啲係手機收到嘅短信，連手機舊主人刪除咗嘅相都揾到。除咗截取記錄，由我身仲可以知道手機主人而家忙緊啲乜嘢。
甚至大家有冇見到佢著過相機啦？咁你正常都唔見嘅。不過而家嘅相片咧，原來咧就已經存在喺黑客嘅電腦上。
楊和森話：裝咗防毒軟件，不能夠100%綁住呢啲黑客軟件。打開封有毒嘅電郵，下載一個 Apps 都可能會中招。
佢呢個裝完係好簡單嘅啫，我哋可以咧經常包裝嚟嗰單中間嘅某啲零件，佢可以包裝喺零件上邊咁樣。如果中意打零嘅十分鐘上邊再包嘅時候，佢嘅技術水平一般使用嘅講係10分或者8分嘅，我下下都已經係好多嘅。
識得自己砌電腦嘅 Jackie， 佢電腦都算係在行。以前電腦中咗毒，佢都覺得難應付。直至舊年7月，佢發現屋企嘅電腦可能被入侵。佢經常使用嘅網上付款戶口 PayPal 突然多咗一轉帳，筆錢轉咗做波蘭錢，過咗會俾一個喺東歐佢唔識嘅人，但佢就冇好似平時咁收到通知電郵。佢向 PayPal 投訴，最終筆錢攞得翻。不過 PayPal 嘅回覆就令佢有啲驚訝。
根據我哋記錄咧，個 IP address 咧係你府上嗰個 IP address 嚟嘅。咁呢樣嘢更加令我覺得恐懼啦。代表啲咩咧？個 hacker 根本就係入侵咗我部電腦，控制我部電腦狀態。
事後佢重新設定部遊戲，用咗防毒軟件改曬所有嘅密碼。不過冇幾耐，佢再發現 PayPal 多咗一筆可疑轉帳，佢即時用電話上網查下電郵有冇轉帳通知。
咁我就 check 到個 email 係有一秒係 pop 咗有一個 transaction， 即係轉錢走嘅影響，但一秒之後就消失咗。咁我嗰一下真係望住咧，我係好懷疑，嚇點解會咁嘅咧？我即時聯想到就係。咁我屋企自己用嘅電腦咧，我有一個少少嘅問題。
中小企老闆頂層每日嘅例行公事就係刪除呢啲垃圾嘅人。
我都係嘅，話誒你個 email 上面 set 好咗，咁都幾多嘅，差唔多人都有一個或者兩個嗰啲啦。啊，琴日我又收到有一個係我哋其中一個人嘅名嘅，但係就嗰個地方或者嗰邊嗰度咧，第一時間會將佢 set 咗 scan。
點解要咁小心咧？前年佢一個喺外國嘅客户問佢點解改咗入數户口都唔準通知佢，佢先知道有人扮佢寄電郵俾客，叫客人過户到另一個海外户口，然後就開始發現客人嘅蹤跡。
我哋都諗唔到咁犀利，佢扮我哋講嘢，都有扮佢幫改咗佢哋嘅 email 嘅domain，因為通常呢啲 email 都唔接受嘅，我幾個人嘅，咁我哋都唔會做佢 email。
咁就事後即時改曬公司所有電郵嘅密碼，不過冇幾耐，客人又再出現。佢喺美國嘅熟客嘅一間細公司過咗幾萬蚊俾個黑客，當發現係騙案報警嗰陣，嗰個户口已經取消咗。事後 Anita 只能寄貨俾人，算係分擔損失。公司先後三次發現黑客，佢哋報警。
其實記者都同我講，我哋幫唔到你嘅喎，因為呢啲係跨境嘅事情。我哋唯有自己小心咯，因為真係冇人幫到嘅。當我哋要收錢嘅時候，小心啲再同客講翻多次，一定係換翻嚟呢個户口，唔好換另一個户口，即係自己行多步。
公司人人都用電腦，亦都可能係有人唔小心令公司系統被黑客多次入侵。員工 Anna 同第一嘅客人通過電郵，佢話而家上網會小心好多。
以前即係我都用上 QQ 啊嗰啲，你知有時有啲八卦新聞啊，咁即時彈出嚟嗰啲，我會追落去睇下咩事啊咁。咁但係而家我會留意啦，都冇睇呢封 email， 跟住咧就 attach 個 root 嘅 file， 即係一句嘢就係話你做咗 payment 啊，我就會知道啦呢啲係假㗎啦。好似雞毒㗎，你會諗下啲無端端點解有個錢掉落嚟嘅地方。
你對千變萬化現象無處不在嘅黑客，聽到人如果話小心啲，譬如冇用公眾電腦 WiFi 輸入個人資料，之外，大型嘅金融機構又係需要為大家轉帳，至高啲嘅保安形式咧。今集時間差唔多，下次未見，再見。
Okay, I think it's a very entertaining episodes to help give you a head start to understand what is meant by information security and privacy. Unfortunately, this is in Cantonese, so if you cannot understand Cantonese, my apologies. I have a lot of information, resources, and English. Okay? So, today, let's point from here, and I'm going to stop talking. And for the remaining 15 minutes, I'll let you ask a question if you have any, okay? Now remember, it's very important that you come back to this website, that this is week number one, and what you need to do after today is to make sure you visit each one of this link to understand the context of this course, the expectations in this course, your commitment in this course, work to be performed, okay? And how it's being accessed, and how you're going to get the grade, okay? Something like this. And I've just used some information in day number two to give you a head start. Now, if you are conscious enough of what to learn, if I were you, okay, I would make the best use of this documentary, watch them again, and try to single out examples of attack, examples of weaknesses that we often commit, okay? And it's going to be a very good discussion. For those of you who do not have a question yet, make sure now use your mobile device, get online into the Moodle environment, and once you're in this Moodle environment, come to the header blog. Here we have a social discussion forum. Click into this header box, social discussion forum, and leave a hello message, okay? Hello, I am John. I'm from the economics department. I'm with perhaps a SPC, Presidential College. Okay, could you do it now? try to see if you can get online to this Moodle environment. In case you do not know how to get here, come to web course. Type on your server webcourse.umac.mo, and once you got to this page, click UM Moodle. Okay? And once you are in UM Moodle, if you are not logged in yet, you can see this button called login button. So click this login, and then you will be brought to this login page. Here, you type your student ID, okay, just like in your email address. For me, it's this one, pclan.umac.mo, and then the password is your email password. Okay, and then you log in. Once you're logged in, you can see a list of courses that you are doing this semester, and look for the course called 2015_1CISG113 Section 1. And once you're in this course, go to the header block and click this link called Social Forum. And once you're in the Social Forum, click Add a New Discussion Topic. Hello, class, or greetings, whatever you want, and then type a simple message. I am Mary. I am from Faculty of Social Science. I'm in communications major. I live in perhaps Sorbonne College. Okay? Hello. Say hello to the whole class. Okay? Just do it now. I think you can manage to do it in within 10 minutes' time. Meanwhile, I'm going to do class attendance. I'm going back to the first block, okay, where I have class attendance here. And then I'm going to create a class attendance record for today. So, 25th, and our class starts at 1 o'clock. It's 1 hour and 15 minutes. Okay? And the description is day 1. See that I got the records here, and so I could start doing attendance call the old way with the electronic records here. So I click here, and so I'm going to call your name, and you please raise your hand. Takasi, are you here? Thank you. Gasi, are you here? Gasi. Okay, you're not here, give you an A. Johnson, thank you. And then Wai Dong. Are you here, White Dong? Not here, okay. And then it's Zagru, Asterio. Are you here? Ga Ho, are you here? Not here, okay. Max, thank you. And then RC, are you here? Thank you. All right, the rest of you continue your message. Human, thank you. Austin, thank you. Ga Shun, thank you. And then is Ho Wang. Are you here? Thank you. Jun Man, Jun Ma, Jun Na. Are you here, Jun Ma? Not here yet. Okay. And then Yu Yin, Yu Yin. Thank you. And then it's Si Man. Are you here? Thank you. And then Ern Yun Yin. Thank you. K, thank you. And then is Ji Tong. Are you here, Ji Tong? Thank you. And then Qing Long, thank you. And then Hiu Yi, are you here? Thank you. And then it's Man Jing, Man Jing, Man Jing。第二一 ，Thank you。啊，袁莹 ，Thank you。Right, very good。啊 ，Hoi Yu，Thank you。啊 ，Abby，Thank you。Oh, Yu Yu。And then it's Wing Ji。Thank you. And then point me. Point me. Not yet. Okay. And then let me say attendance first. It's not yet finished. So. And then point ye. Are you here? Not yet. Okay. And then Jun Wei. Thank you. Yep, Yip Fei, Yip Fei, thank you. Sam, thank you. Fleming, thank you. Junior, Junior, not here yet, okay. And then Ivan.
Sorry, sir.
You're here, okay, sorry for that. And then it's Benjamin, thank you. Alright, so it's Kiwi. Thank you. Kiwi. So, Helen. Are you here, Helen? Not yet. Okay. Sean. Sean. Are you here? Thank you. And then Oscar. Thank you. Thank you very much. Jing. Jing Ma. Jing Ma. Thank you. Shan Ni. Shan Ni. Thank you. Mabel. Thank you. Alright, so it's Gai, thank you. And then Stanley, thank you. Wu Dong Yang, Dong Yang, yeah, Dong Yang is not here yet, right? Okay, that's very good. Hoi Yun, Hoi Yun, Hai Yun, Hai Yun. Okay, anyway, Hoi Yi, Hoi Yi, not here yet, okay. Kitty, thank you. So we go. And then Ji Yang, thank you. Iris, thank you. And then it's Wai Yip, thank you. Thank you very much. Sam again, thank you. And yes, let me see the attendance now. It should be okay this time. It takes about 5 minutes time to do that. So I do. Oh, still some more. Joao, Joao, are you here? Joao, no, not yet. Yen, your name, thank you. Ivaldo, thank you. Jiang, 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 are you here? Jiang, 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 not yet, I'm sorry. Yokun, Yokun, thank you. And then Kilian. Zihang, thank you. Okay. Kathy, Kathy, thank you. Okay, it's almost done. Let's see. That's good. I finished the attendance form. Now it's 2:10. Now, if you do have any, do not have any questions, and so save it for first day. I need one for another class. I need to get there before 2:30. Alright, so please make sure to visit the links there in the your module environment, study the syllabus, and ask questions be it on the open discussion forum or your private forum channels. Okay, so allow me to pack up and walk. Alright, so thank you very much for today. It's the first day on CISU 113, Section 1, August the 25th, 2015. Until this first day, see you. Thank you. message through the UR Moodle environment. Okay?